Hi, this is Viv from Plugin Republic. In this video, we're going to look at how to create a WooCommerce product list. While the default WooCommerce shop page layout is visually appealing, showcasing 3 to 4 products per row, it's not always the best option for every business. Some stores need a visually different way to showcase products. Having your products in a list allows you to display more products per page and to set which details you want to display for the products. By arranging the information in rows and columns, you make it easier for your customer to scan multiple products at a time. In turn, this means fewer clicks to buy a product, which potentially means more revenue for you. To create a product list in WooCommerce, you'll need the WooCommerce Product Table Ultimate plugin. This lets you list your products in rows and columns, choosing which columns you want. Customers can simply tick the checkboxes next to the items they'd like to purchase and add them to the cart in a single click. You can display the product tables anywhere on your WooCommerce store. You can even replace the standard shop and archive layouts with a list. The first thing you need to do is get the WooCommerce Product Table Ultimate plugin. When you purchase the plugin, you'll receive an email with a download link and license key. Just download the zip file to your computer. Add the plugin from Plugins, Add New. When it's uploaded, click Activate. Once that's done, head over to WooCommerce, Settings, Product Table Ultimate, License, and enter the license key. Now that you have the WooCommerce Product Table Ultimate plugin installed on your WordPress site, you can start configuring its settings. The plugin's configuration options determine how the WooCommerce product list appears on your site's front end. Navigate to WooCommerce Settings Product Table Ultimate from the admin panel to get started. There are only a few settings which makes it quick and easy to get started with the plugin. You can set these globally here, but then override them for specific product lists. We'll take a look at that later. The first setting we'll look at is the Columns field. This lets you decide which columns you'd like to display in the front-end product list. For example, you might consider displaying the product's thumbnail image, name, categories, description, price, and Add to Cart button. For this, you'd simply enter thumbnail, name, categories, short description, price, Add to Cart in the Columns field. Ensure that you separate each one with a comma. Click Save and you can see how this looks on the front end. We have the columns we specified. The Show Quantities on Add to Cart column option lets you decide whether you'd like to display quantity selectors in the product table. If you want to give customers the option to set the quantity of the product they'd like to purchase, then you should set this field to Yes. This will add a quantity field next to the Add to Cart button. The Product Source field lets you specify which WooCommerce products to display in the product list. You can set it to display all products, products from categories or tags, or even the results of a custom query. Remember that these are the global settings, so you can choose different products to display on different pages from the individual page settings. Variations Display determines how you display variable products. You either list variations as drop-downs in the parent product row, as separate rows, so each variation is a separate row in the list, or redirect the user to the product page. Let's take a look at that on the front end. The Order Table By field lets you decide the sort order of the WooCommerce product list. You can choose to order by the product ID, title, price, date, popularity, rating, or menu order. And you can choose to sort products in ascending order or descending order. If you want to display the latest products first, you'd set the Order Table By field to Date and the Order option to Descending. That shows our most recent products first. The Products Per Page field lets you enable pagination, and decide how many WooCommerce products to list on a single page. If you'd like to disable pagination and display all products on a single page, you can set this field to 0. The Enable Add Selected button is a crucial feature. Set this to Yes to display a checkbox at the start of each row in the product table. This way, customers will be able to browse through the list, select multiple products, and add them all to their order with a single click. Let's see that in action on the front end. Here we can scan down the list and select multiple products, then add them all to the cart with one click. If we go back to the settings, on the layout tabs, there's some further functionality. Sortable columns allows you to specify one or more columns that the user can sort the table on, so they could sort by product name, price, etc. Filterable columns allows the user to filter the list by certain columns. So if you choose categories here, then the user could filter products in certain categories in the list, like this. There are a couple of different methods for displaying the filters, either by a selectable drop-down list or by clicking the items themselves in the list. Okay, so that's a quick overview of the main product settings. Let's look at how to display product lists on your site's front end. There are two ways to display the product list on your site's front end, either using a block or a shortcode. Regardless of which method you choose to go with, you'll need to first create a page to add the product table. To do this, navigate to Pages, Add New from the WordPress admin panel, and give your page a title. If you're using the block editor to add your product list, then click the new block icon and search for the Product Table Ultimate block. This will automatically add the product table to the content editor. You will also be able to edit its parameters from the block menu on the right. Remember that these settings will inherit from the global settings that we looked at previously, but if you want to tweak or enter different settings altogether, you can do so here. This gives you loads of flexibility with your lists. You can create as many as you like, all with different settings. When you preview the page on the front end, you'll see your product list. If you decide to use a shortcode to add the product list, all you have to do is enter the following shortcode in the page content where you'd like the list to appear. Open square bracket, product underscore table underscore ultimate, close square bracket. Just as with the block, the shortcode will inherit the global settings. If you want to deviate from those, you can add some parameters to your shortcode. For example, we can change which products to display with the list by using categories equal open quotes 25 close quotes to specify that we want to list products from specific categories, then add to pull in products from the category with the ID 25. There's a full list of these shortcode parameters in the documentation. Finally, what about if you wanted to change your shop or archive pages into a list view? You can do that easily by going back to the Global Product Table Ultimate settings and selecting which pages to display as product lists. We can choose the shop page, plus all category pages like this. Then they'll be displayed as lists on the front end. So when you activate this, the standard shop and archive layout switches to a product list view instead. So that's how to create a product list in WooCommerce. You just need the WooCommerce Product Table Ultimate plugin. For more information, check out the resources section on the Plugin Republic website, where you'll find dozens of tutorials and case studies. Thanks for watching, and make sure you hit the like and subscribe buttons.